here is a smart new way of arranging complex meeting with many busy people. Typically, we have to negotiate the time slot with many people. You need many calls, chats, emails to finalize the slot. But now, with scheduling poll, you can eliminate all that manual activity and finalize a meeting quickly and smartly. Create a meeting, add attendees, and then click on the scheduling poll button. If you can't see the button on the desktop version, try the browser version of Outlook. It opens a new pane on the right side. Select the duration and the date. It'll show you a list of all available slots and also give you a tally about how many people are available, how many people are already busy. We want to give people alternatives, so choose another date and another set of time slots. Choose multiple time slots and then click the next button. Now it shows you the selected time slots. Make sure that the Teams meeting option is on and also shows some more options. Just keep the default options for now and click on the create poll button. It creates a new email with link to the poll. Send the mail. Now each invitee receives a mail, and in that mail there is a vote button that opens a browser page which gives them all available options. For each available time slot, you can say prefer, yes or no. You can also see tally of what other people have said about each slot. Click the vote button to submit your vote. While the voting is going on, all the slots are tentatively blocked. That's called putting it on hold. The organizer will get notifications about every vote. During voting, if there is an automatic consensus about a time slot, the meeting is automatically arranged. Of course, as an organizer, you can go to your own poll, look at the status, and choose a specific slot without waiting for the consensus to happen. Using the View All Polls option, you can monitor multiple such polls at different levels of completion. Here are the default settings, which you can customize on a per poll basis. It is a good idea to keep the notifications on. It's also good to automatically create the meeting when consensus is reached. That was the whole purpose of this automation. Hold selected times is a good idea, otherwise you may end up blocking time for some other meeting and have an overlap. Use lock poll if you don't want attendees to be able to suggest a new time. The duration, of course, you'll have to change on a per meeting basis. And limit suggestions to meeting hours is of course a good option, because we don't want to force people to work beyond office hours. So there you have it. A brilliant, smart way of arranging complex meetings with multiple busy people involved. You must try it out before you get the confidence to use it in real life. If you have any questions, feel free to post them. And of course, like, share, subscribe. So that's it for now. Thank you. See you next time.